No! Oh, wrong button. Maybe it's weird, but yeah, that's just how I roll, apparently. I see a picture of a silhouette of a man. No, I see a picture of an eyeshadow palette. Wow, that was very random. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today is another Let's Talk Makeup new makeup releases. It's number 51. Yes. And today is actually a very special day because it's my mother's birthday. So yeah, I don't think she'll appreciate it if I tell you how old she is. So you did not just see it flashing in the screen. She always says that she is 35 and the rest is experience. So happy birthday, mommy dearest. I love you to bits and I will see you. Well, I want to say I will see you tonight, but I have already seen you because this goes live in the evening for us. And I will have already eaten cake and such and drank coffee and wished her a happy birthday in person this afternoon. At least that's the plan. So yeah, the makeup look I have on my face I filmed. It is my first impression with the Lemon palette by Beauty Glaze. And I'm planning to have it up this week. I don't know exactly when, but I'm planning to have it up this week. Just so you know. So yeah, if you want to see how I created this look and what I feel about that little palette, you just have to stay tuned on my channel. So this video is based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist is down in my description box, as is the community playlist that she was kind enough to create for, well, people such as me who do these types of videos. So if you like these types of videos, you can click on the playlist and then just binge watch and see, well, everyone's opinions on makeup. Because that's basically what the series is about. So yeah, did I say it's 51? Yeah, I think I did, didn't I? Yeah, I'm just going to, oh yeah, what else is in my description box, the sources that I use to make this video happen every single week are also down in my description box. I use multiple sources, so yeah, if you want to follow me on Instagram, you can, because my handle is also in my description box. It's a full description box, people. There are some discount codes there. I try to list the makeup that I wear, if I have any room left, and usually the products that I mention in the video are down there as well. That's it. The intro was way too long, so I'm going to go to the side so that I can put the pictures up there. I also have my water here because it's pretty warm here still. The weather is actually really, really nice. It's kind of like summer weather, but with a hint of the freshness of autumn, you know? This kind of weather I could live with all year round, to be quite honest with you. But yeah, I tried to kind of group brands together. And that's where it ends. So I don't have a specific drugstore section and then the rest. It's all jumbled up. But I hope I have all the brands together. But you never know. So let's just start with... No! Oh, wrong button. Let's start with iHeart Revolution. And you see here this. It's the iHeart Revolution Toy Factory. And when I first saw it, I was like, that's probably something like perfume. But apparently, they are palettes. They're so cute. You have Rosy, which is the rose gold. Then Honey, which is the gold. And then Lulu is the pink and Jet is the black. These little beauties are coming soon to iHeart Revolution, but they're not done, which you will see about in just a second. But yeah, from my understanding, these are palettes. And I actually cannot wait to see the inside because I'm really, really curious. I think this is cute. Shoot me. I think it's cute. The next thing that I have is this. This is called Pet Shop. We are so happy to share this. Pun intended, I think. I don't know what these are. I don't know. Maybe they are highlighter palettes. The only thing is, though, that this would have been cuter in spring, I think, you know, because the hair and then spring and... Now, kinda, I'm kinda into the mood for skulls and that kind of pumpkins and ghosties and that kind of thing. So if it was that, I would be all over the moon. But, well, wait. Well, you know what I mean. But I cannot wait to see what these are. I'm very, very curious. So if I know more, I will let you know, of course. The last thing that I have from iHeart Revolution is Stop, Pop and Cherry. That's what they say. Take a closer look at the brand new Cherry Lip Vinyl Collection with 8 head-turning reds. You're sure to pick your perfect pop. I think this is perfect for the time of year we are in. And yeah, I think I just need to try some because, yeah. They are available now at revolutionbeauty.com. They retail for £4, €5 or $6. And yeah, they are very, very pretty. So yeah, there's more that I kind of want from Makeup Revolution again. So maybe I will order one or two of these lippies as well. Okay, next is from Melt actually, because they are revealing, or yeah, this is from their Radioactive collection. It launches in September. You have the Radioactive palette, the Gamma Ray blush light, and the liquid lipsticks in Atomic Purple and Super Heat. That eyeshadow palette looks so pretty. I don't know if it's all mattes or that you also have shimmers. I cannot really tell. I think it's a combination. I think that the tealy one is a shimmer and then the lavendery one is a shimmer. And maybe the rest are mattes. I don't know. But it looks really pretty. And I also love the packaging. The highlighter. Is that a highlighter? Oh, the blush. Yeah, no, not really. And then the lipsticks look gorgeous as well. And they look to complement the eyeshadow palette really, really well. So it's probably going to be pretty expensive. I think Melt is sold at Beauty Bay. I don't know how long it will take for this to drop there. I don't think it will take long though. I do think it's really, really pretty. And if I were to get anything from Melt, it will probably be this, to be quite honest with you. Because, yeah, the rest is pretty. You know, those two green palettes were really, really pretty. But this, yeah. I'm very, very curious. Let me know down below what you think of it. Next is Nomad Cosmetics. They have released 2 eyeshadow palettes, Lake Como and Tuscany. The trouble with these though is I have 2 separate pictures under different lighting, I think. So this picture that you see here, the first one which says Italia on the top, the colors are a little bit more vibrant than the second picture which I will put underneath. Because there they look a little bit more muted. So I kind of hope they are more like the first picture, you know, with the word Italia on it, than the second one, to be quite honest. They retail for $27 each. Is it all mattes? I think it's mattes and shimmers. I like the embossing on it. Yeah, I'm not hating them. It's just that I kind of hope that they are a little bit more vibrant. So again, the first picture, then the second picture. But I think they're pretty looking at the first picture. The second picture, they're kind of blah. But yeah, let me know down below what you think of it. And if you have tried anything from Nomad Cosmetics. Next is Rimmel. They have a new lasting matte concealer. The lightweight and hydrating formula instantly hides any blemishes, spots and dark circles. I have no idea how long it will take to get here. We have Rimmel here in stores, but still, you know, that I think it's Rimmel, the foundation with the yellow cap, the new foundations. I have not seen in stores yet here. So, yeah, but they sound really interesting. You know, a matte concealer, but still lightweight and hydrating. Yeah, I could see myself trying these if I see them in store. Okay, so the next one is from Classy Cake Cosmetics, as she is a very, very, very tiny indie brand. She also has a YouTube channel and her handle is called My Real California Life. I will link her channel down in the description box. But she has come out with a multi-chrome palette. And this looks so pretty. But yeah, let me know down below if you have tried anything from Classy Cake Cosmetics. I know a few of my friends here on YouTube have. And from my understanding, her formula is really, really good. So let me know down below. And again, these look very, very pretty. So, yeah. Okay, next is Juvia's Place. Let's start with this one first, which is the Warrior 3 eyeshadow palette. It's up for pre-sale now. You see the picture here. And it says limited quantities available on the website. So I don't know if this is a limited edition or if it's just, I don't know, a pre-launch, which is pretty weird because Juvia's place is kind of big now. So I don't really know what's up with that. I don't know how many pallets they have, because yeah, 5,000 is still limited quantity. You know what I mean? So yeah, I also don't really know what I think about this, to be honest with you. I want to see some reviews first. I'm not hating this palette at all. It's just that when I saw the front, I thought the inside would look a little bit differently. Does that make any sense? It looks pretty, but I am not completely sold yet. So yeah, I need to see. I know Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner just got it, so I want to see how it performs and what the colors look like, because it's always difficult, for me at least, to kind of judge how the colors really look when they're in a palette. That is why I love swatches so much, because then I can kind of get a better feel for the colors. Maybe it's weird, but yeah, that's just how I roll, apparently. The next thing that I have is this. This is a sneak peek from Juvia's place called The Nomad. And some people are saying, oh yeah, because of the hat, it will probably be Halloween-y. I kind of hope it will be, yeah. But maybe it's kind of neon-y, because basically you can go either way with this palette. If you see the artwork behind her, it's kind of neon-y colors. But if you look at her, it's neutral. So I don't know what it is. If they have released the picture of the inside when you are seeing this, I will have put it up. Otherwise, yeah, you'll just have to wait, and we will probably talk about it next week. I'm curious. Okay. I saw this from Beauty News Official, and yeah, it's a picture of the Viseart Dark Edit palette and swatches that they will release soon. I really like this color story, guys. I don't have Viseart money, so I will not be getting it. I know more because I need to scroll a little bit further. It says here launching on the 1st of September, so it has already launched when you are seeing this. And it retails on Beautylish for $39. So that's actually, yeah, it's still expensive, but it's not the Natasha Denona expensive. So yeah. Huh. I'm going to keep my eye on this one. What am I doing now? I don't know. Let's just keep it at that. Let me know down below what you think of it. Am I still recording? Yes, good. This is from Santa Maria Beauty. It's the La Reina del Sol. I know I'm butchering it and I'm trying here. It is $16 and it is available now on the site. This is technically, when I look at it, I was kind of debating how am I going to describe this palette, because for me it's not a yellow palette. It is a neutral palette with yellow. Does that make any sense? I'm not hating this palette though. I think it's very smart that they put in the black, because one of the complaints of almost everyone with the Colourpop palette was the fact that it wasn't deep enough. Midas Cosmetics also, I think that the brown was, from what I understood, the brown that was in there, too light for most people. So I think it's very, very good idea that they put in a black. I just wish, personally, that they would have put in more yellows. Especially because there is Sol in the name, which is sun. So yeah, maybe more yellow, maybe more orange, maybe less brown. But that is just me. I have never heard of this brand before. I don't know the quality as well. So if you have, let me know down below how it is, because I'm curious. I always like finding indie brands that I've never heard of. So let's go to something that is maybe a little bit in the middle. That's this from, what was this, Too Faced? I think it is. It is a holiday palette. It's their Christmas edition themed palette. It launches in September, but Too Faced is kind of showing us a lot of holiday stuff. So I don't know what is in the collection. Yeah, a lot of eyeshadow palettes, a lot of different eyeshadow palettes, but I'm actually not really hating this one. I'm kind of liking this one. And that is probably because it has a little more color to it than the other palettes. So yeah, I don't know how practical it would be to store, but I'm not really hating this palette. Is it boring? Yeah, maybe. I don't know. Let me know your thoughts down in the description box, because I'm curious to see what you think of this. I am not hating this. I think that from all the palettes that Too Faced are launching for Christmas already, I think that this is the most exciting one. So yeah, color story wise, that is. Next is this. I saw this from Beaudiction. The video is up on her channel on Wet n Wild Halloween palettes. If I can find it, I probably can find it. I will link it down in my description box. It is a quick 5-minute review. Review is what she says, swatches and comparison to some other palettes. I kind of like these. And the one that I actually like the most is the one with the red and then the silvery, gray silvery shades in it. I think that is, maybe that is a new theme, because I saw Makeup Obsession do something like this. Lime Crime is doing something like this, and Wet n Wild has also something like this. So yeah, I don't know. I haven't seen her video as I am filming this this video. But yeah, that one looks really, really interesting. Let me know down below what you think of it. I don't think I can get these here. I can get some from Wet n Wild here, but not everything. Or maybe I can. Maybe these will come to the Netherlands. I don't know yet. I don't know. So ColourPop has a new collection. Of course they do. But this is an Ulta exclusive collection. It is called the X's and O's. And it is berry toned, I think. So yeah, you have the palette that retails for $16. Which is a mix of metallic and matte eyeshadows. Then you have an ultra blotted lips for $7. And an ultra glossy lips for $7. It is available now online. And I also think in stores, but I'm not sure. So yeah, it does not really matter what I think of it, because I cannot get it. I cannot shop at Ulta. But I did want to mention it, because I kind of find it pretty. So there's that. So yeah. Okay, next is from... So yeah...
I'm very, very confused at the moment. But anyway, let's go to Pacifica Beauty, because they have launched a hemp infused line. That's what kind of confuses me, because I have a bunch of pictures here, and I will read what the post says from Beauty News officials. You have a Cosmic Reflect hemp infused eyeshadow palette for $19. Then you have the Tiger's Eye hemp infused eyeshadows for $10. A Highest Gloss hemp infused for chronic... What? Shine Lip Gloss Balm for $8 in 3 shades. And then a Highest Lash Chronic Volume Mascara. I see a picture of a silhouette of a man. No, I see a picture of an eyeshadow palette. Wow, that was very random. Which looks really pretty. Actually, and then I see a Tiger's Eye... eyeshadow, and I see, I don't know, what the hell is that? Let me zoom in. That's also eyeshadow. Huh? See, I don't get it. That first picture with the large eyeshadow palette, is that the one for $19? I don't know. Because that one is very, very pretty. I am very, very confused by the second picture that I have here, which has Tiger's Eye palette and then another palette, or is that just the same but then in different packaging? I don't know, and I kind of... Oh wait, the outer and the inner. Never mind. Yes, I'm hungry. And apparently I'm eating up my own brain cells from the inside out. But yeah, so... the big eyeshadow palette, which retails for $19, is the big eyeshadow palette, which looks really pretty. I like it. I don't give a rat's ass if it is hemp infused or not. I don't care one way or the other. I really do not. Mascara, yeah, that's nice, but I use falsies a lot of the time anyway. I wanted to mention it because I know a lot of people kind of like that hemp stuff in their makeup and skincare. I don't care one way or the other, but I do think that this eyeshadow palette is really pretty. So yeah, let me know if you have tried anything from Pacifica Beauty and how the quality is. Oh, it's available now on Ulta Beauty. Next is from Funko Pop, the Villains eyeshadow collection. These are so... No, well, the Villain collections, actually.
They're so cute. So freaking cute. I like those dolls. I don't collect them, but I do like them. I think they're cute. But this is so cute. This is a collaboration between Original Funko and Disney. It's the villain collection. You have, let me see, Ursula, Maleficent, Cruella de Vil, and the Evil Queen. Each character has a distinct color palette theme, which includes eyeshadow palettes, face palettes, glosses, eyeliner, and makeup brushes. How cool. But I think it's only available at Ulta. Which I'm so very sad about. Because I really, really like this. It's not fair. Just so you know. So yeah, it will be available September online at Ulta Beauty and stores. And it's exclusive. And I'm kind of pissed off about it. Because I want to buy something like this. That purple one is so cute. The red one, well, the only thing that I'm not really interested in is the yellow eyeshadow palette. The rest, I would be happy to own. Yeah. So, why can I not get, I hope we can get it outside of the US as well. Soon. But yeah, it would be very cute for Christmas or something like that. Yeah? Okay. Last week, I mentioned the Morphe Jeffree Star Round 3. And here you see a picture of what round 3 entails. It's lippies and brushes. Let's see. So you have two lip sets. One is an Iconic Bold 5-piece mini lip collection. The lip sets retail for $25. You have in the bold one a velour liquid lipstick in Unicorn Blood and one in Red Rum. Then you have a lip gloss in Berry Blast, a lip gloss in Iconic, and then a lip topper in Living For It. You also have a nudes one. Which is the velour lipstick in Mannequin and one in Leo. And then a gloss in Star Crown and in First Impression. And then a lip topper in Slurp. Then you have a brush set and a bag for $49. I'm not really interested in the brushes, to be quite honest with you. I am, however, interested in the lip sets. I'm curious. Are they his formula or Morphe's formula? Because basically, these are, yeah, a lot cheaper than his own mini lip sets. I'm curious. I'm also really interested. It's available tomorrow, the 3rd. So yeah. Okay. Next is a new eyeshadow palette by Dominique Cosmetics. It is the Celestial Storm. And she's so pretty. Wow. I would love to have this one. To be quite honest with you. I think I can get Dominique Cosmetics through Beauty Bay. I believe. It will be online September the 4th. She's very, very pretty. I don't know what her palettes retail for. But she's gorgeous. Yeah. Definitely on my wish list. Definitely. Let me know your thoughts down below. Okay, next is Jouer. They have unveiled their limited edition Metamorphosis collection. And it says here, for every palette purchased from 9, 10, 19, what's that? The 10th of September, I think, until the 10th of September. No, 10th of October, so for 1 month, wow. 15% of the net proceeds will be donated to the non-profit Chrysalis organization. So, yeah, that's good. That's always a very, very good thing. And you have a face and eye palette, which retail for $34. Essential Lip Enhancer Shine Balm in two colors, retail for $18. A Metamorphosis Collection Bundle retails for $70. Yeah, it launches the 10th of September. So for one whole month, 15% of the net proceeds will go to the Chrysalis organization. I'm not specifically hating it. It's not for me, but I kind of like those mauvey, dusty colors. I think it looks pretty. Again, it's not for me, but I do think it looks pretty. They have a good cause. So if this is something that you are interested in, you can get it from the 10th of September at Jouer.com. Okay, so we have another rainbow palette. This time one from Yas Glitters and Makeup by Abby. It's a collaboration. It's so pretty. It says here 10 colorful mattes and 5 shimmers. So the mattes are rainbowy and then the shimmers are the last row, I think. I think that's actually a very brilliant idea to get the colorful mattes and then very light paley shimmers to go with it. Yeah. I'm not hating the palette. I love the rainbow. I love colors. So why wouldn't I love a rainbow? It is just another rainbow palette with a little bit of variation in it. I'm not hating it. But yeah, let me know what you think and if you have tried anything from Yas Glitters and if it is worth it. Where are they based? I have no freaking idea. Oh, US based. And they have worldwide shipping. They are cruelty free. So yeah, that's good. Okay, let's go to another collab with another influencer. This time though, it's with Angelica Nyquist and Divina Cosmetics. She has created a bundle. It's just her picks and there are 2 new shades in here and the rest is just what is already in the collection and she curated the palette. That is how she explained it. Here you see the names and the swatches. She also did a few videos, I think three looks with her bundle, something like that. But yeah, I think it's very, very pretty. I haven't seen her video yet where she explains why she picked all the shades, but I do think it's very, very pretty. So yeah, it looks gorgeous, to be quite honest with you. It's called the Moonwell Bundle. It has launched already. It's a 12 shade bundle. It retails for $48. Zana and Delirium were only sold as highlighters, but because she used them as eyeshadows as well, they are in this bundle. But you can also buy the bundle of both in 26mm sizes for $8 with code. Bundle is limited edition but will restock if it sells out. And you can use the code ANJESHKA20 for money off. And no other codes will apply to this collection. And I actually think that's a good thing. Because, you know, it's her bundle or her curated bundle. So it should just be her code. Yeah, that's just how I feel. It's the same with the Paulina palette. I think that only Paulina's code should have been good with that palette, but that is me. It is the code, by the way, that I used for that palette, but that's again just me. So yeah, it looks really, really pretty. It is above my price range, especially now, but yeah, I think it's gorgeous. It's gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. So yeah, I have one thing left, which is this is That Girl Cosmetics. They are based in the UK. I think it's a new brand though. The eyeshadow palette retails for £25, which is, well, mid-range. Yeah, that's about $30, I think. And then the lashes retail from £10 and up. So, yeah, they have worldwide shipping as well. I think the palette looks cute. That's basically it. The palette looks cute. Let me know what you think about it. And maybe, yeah, the collection is live already. Maybe you have already tried it. Let me know down below. So guys, this was it for my Let's Talk Makeup New Makeup Releases number 51. Let me know down below what you thought of the products that I talked about. Maybe you have a different opinion. And then let me know yours. And let's chat about it in the comment section. If you tag me, thank you so very, very much. And yeah, if you think that I missed something, let me know down below as well. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you soon in my next one, which could very well be tomorrow, but I'm not sure yet. So there's that. Bye, guys. Oh, I'm so hungry. I could eat a horse. Oh no, I'm vegan.